السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله على أسمائه وصفاته وعلى ما أنعم ومن به على عباده، ثم الصلاة والسلام على عبد الله ورسوله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين.
All praises to Allah for His names and His attributes and for the many blessings that He has bestowed upon His slaves. And then may the greetings of Allah and His exaltations be upon the Prophet Muhammad and his family and his companions, all of them.
أما بعد فكلمتنا في هذه الليلة والتي نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينفع بها القائل والسامع حول السعادة في الدارين والطريق إليها.
The talk that we are about to give tonight, that we ask Allah to make it beneficial for the one who delivers it and the one who receives it, is revolving around the topic of reaching happiness in both this life and the life to come, and how it is that that can be attained.
ولا يخفى علينا بارك الله فيكم أن الحياة السعيدة والحياة الطيبة مطلب كل إنسان، بل هي مطلب الأفراد والجماعات والغاية التي يسعى إليها كل فرد ويسمو إليها كل إنسان.
And it is not hidden from any of you, may Allah bless you all, that a happy life is the ultimate goal of each of us. It is the ultimate goal of individuals and groups. In fact, every person strives towards that goal.
فكل من على وجه الأرض يعمل جاهدا للفوز بها ويسعى كذلك لتحقيقها.
In fact, every individual on the face of this globe is striving and putting in effort and diligently working towards the achievement of that goal, which is happiness, to attain happiness.
فقد اختلف الناس على اختلاف مللهم وأديانهم ومبادئهم في حقيقة الحياة السعيدة. ما هي الحياة السعيدة؟ واختلفوا كذلك في الطريق إليها والسبيل الموصل لها.
However, people have differed. People of different religions, different creeds, different ideologies have differed regarding what is exactly considered a happy life and what is exactly the path that leads to achieving it and reaching it.
فمن الناس من يظن أن السعادة في جمع المال وتكديسه وجمع الثروات وامتلاك العقارات وبناء القصور والفلل.
From the people are those who think that the amassment of wealth and gaining a large portfolio of real estate, pieces of land and buildings and palaces and villas, is the path to happiness.
ولا شك أن هذا مفهوم خاطئ، والدليل على ذلك ما ورد في القرآن الكريم من القصص التي تبين خطأ هذا الظن.
And there is no doubt that this is a misunderstanding, a misconception. And from the evidence that shows so clearly is that which is found in the Quran of stories that refute this misconception.
فهذا قارون كما أخبر الله سبحانه وتعالى عنه في القرآن الكريم آتاه الله من المال ما تعجز جماعة من الناس عن حمل مفاتيح كنوزه، كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى: إن قارون كان من قوم موسى فبغى عليهم وآتيناه من الكنوز ما إن مفاتيحه لتنوء بالعصبة أولي القوة إذ قال له قومه لا تفرح. فكانت نهاية هذا الإنسان الذي أنعم الله عليه بكثرة المال أن خسف الله به وبداره الأرض، كما قال: فخسفنا به وبداره الأرض فما كان له من فئة ينصرونه من دون الله وما كان من المنتصرين.
An example of that is that which is found in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the story of Qarun, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, indeed, Qarun was from the people of Musa, and he exceeded the limits in transgressing against them. And we gave him of the treasures that which its keys would be difficult and burdensome for a group of strong men to carry. When his people said to him, do not be arrogant. Indeed, Allah does not love those who are arrogant. And Allah Azza wa Jal continues the story until Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. So we made the earth split apart and swallow him and swallow his home. And surely he had no group to give him victory besides Allah. And surely he was not from the victorious. تفضل وحسن الله إليكم.
فلو كانت السعادة تبارك الله فيكم في جمع المال وامتلاكه لكان قارون أسعد الناس في الدنيا ولكنه كان من أتعس الناس في الدنيا وذلك لفقده أسباب السعادة وميله عن الطريق إليها.
So if wealth was the key to happiness, then Qarun would surely be the happiest of mankind. However, he was the opposite of that. He was from the most wretched and saddened of mankind because he did not know what are the real reasons that lead to happiness and its achievement and attainment. No.
ومن الناس كذلك من يتوهم أن السعادة تنال بالمناصب واعتلاء الرياسات ولكن هذا فهم خاطئ كذلك فمن الناس من ملك المناصب ووصل إلى أعلى الرياسات الدنيوية ولكن لم يسعد بها بل شقي بها وصارت سببا لهلاكه في الدارين فهذا فرعون قال الله سبحانه وتعالى عنه ونادى فرعون في قومه قال يا قوم أليس لي ملك مصر وهذه الأنهار تجري من تحتها فلا تبصرون.
From amongst people are those as well who think that happiness is attained when status and high ranking positions are achieved. However, this is also a misconception, a misunderstanding.
فقد ذكر فرعون كما أخبر الله سبحانه وتعالى عنه أن السعادة في الرياسة وفي امتلاك الأموال والقصور التي تجري تحتها الأنهار ولكن هذا الظن كان خاطئا لأن نهايته كانت كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى فلما آسفونا انتقمنا منهم فأغرقناهم أجمعين فحياة نهايتها الغرق ومصيرها إلى النار ليست حياة سعد بها صاحبها في الدنيا ولا في الآخرة.
And an example of that is Fir'aun, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us his story and how he had reached the highest of positions and the highest of levels. And he called amongst his people, وَنَادَ فِرْعَوْنُ فِي قَوْمِهِ. He called amongst his people, he said, oh my people, isn't the dominion, the kingdom of Egypt mine? And these rivers flow beneath me. Do you not see?
فِرْعَوْنُ لَمْ يَعْرِفْ حقيقة الحياة السعيدة ولم يهتدي إلى طريقها وإنما كان يفتخر برياسته وبأمواله وكان يحتقر أهل الحق والدين ولكن عرف الحقيقة عندما أحاطت به أسباب الموت وفاتته الفرص عرف في تلك الحالة أن السعادة لا تنال إلا بالدين والإيمان ولهذا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى عن فرعون حتى إذا أدركه الغرق قال آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذي آمنت به بنو إسرائيل وأنا من المسلمين ولكن لم ينفعه ذلك بل قيل له الآن وقد عصيت قبل وكنت من المفسدين.
So here is Fir'aun thinking that his achievement of power and high status and wealth is the key to happiness. However, he turned out to be gravely mistaken, for indeed the affair was as Allah described, فَلَمَّا أَسَفْتُونَ انْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. So when they angered us, we took revenge from them and we drowned them all. What life is considered a happy life if it ends in drowning and then the fire of hell? Surely this is a wretched life. Now, so Fir'aun thought that this was the life that led to happiness. However, he turned out to be mistaken. And he only learned what is truly the reason of happiness when it was too late. When death had surrounded him and it was around him from every angle, from every direction, he recognized that happiness is found in faith. So he said, when drowning was upon him, I have believed that there is no true deity except for the one that Banu Israel, the children of Israel, have believed in. And surely I am from the submitters, from the Muslims. So that did not save him. And it was too late to fix his affair. So it was said to him, is it now that you accept it? While as before, you were disobedient and you were from those who sought corruption, meaning in the land.
ومن الناس كذلك من يحسب أن السعادة تحصل بملذات الدنيا من المآكل والمشارب والملابس والمراكب والمنازل. ولكن الله سبحانه وتعالى كذب زعمهم بقوله فرأيت إن متعناهم سنين ثم جاءهم ما كانوا يوعدون ما أغنى عنهم ما كانوا يمتعون.
And from the people as well are those who think that happiness is attained by having an abundance of things to eat and things to drink and things to wear and dress in and places to live in and take as abode and residence. Have you not seen to the fact that if we were to give them mata', يعني, things to enjoy and provisions to have يعني, the benefit of for many years, and then what they were promised came to them, what is it that the things that they used to enjoy, the benefits that they used to have, can do for them at that point? Meaning once the punishment of Allah arrives, all the things that they had enjoyed for these years that have passed will prove useless. Nah.
وبين الله كذلك سبحانه وتعالى أن ما ظنوا حياة سعيدة ليس إلا سرابا يدوم أياما ثم تكون نهايته إلى الهلاك. قال سبحانه وتعالى ذرهم يأكلوا ويتمتعوا ويلهيهم الأمل فسوف يعلمون.
Allah عز وجل has also showed that what they think is the means of happiness and the secret to having a joyful life is nothing but a mirage. And he showed Azza wa Jal that it ends in sorrow. He said, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, ذَرْهُمْ يَأْكُلُوا وَيَتَمَتَّعُوا وَيُلْهِهِمُ الْأَمَلُ فَسَوْفَ عَلَمُوا. Leave them to eat and leave them to enjoy يعني the many amenities that we have given them. And let al-amal deceive them. Al-amal is having hope that things will continue to be good and things will continue to get better and life will be long and so on. Hope. For indeed they shall come to know, يعني the truth.
وأسوأ الناس حالا من يظن أن السعادة تنال بالكفر بالله سبحانه وتعالى مخالفة أمره ونهيه وبارتكاب المحرمات كشرب الخمور والزنا وغير ذلك من المعاصي التي حرمها الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه وحذر منها رسولنا عليه الصلاة والسلام في سنته.
And the worst of all these groups is the group of those who think that happiness is found in disbelieving in Allah, in having the incorrect creed. Those who think that disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the key to happiness, that happiness is found in the engagement of or in major sins such as drinking and fornication. The engaging in sins that Allah has forbidden us from in His book, and likewise His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbade in His Sunnah.
إذا لم تكن السعادة جمع المال ولا نيل الرئاسات والمناصب ولا التلذذ بملذات الدنيا والتفكه بها وكذلك إذا لم تكن السعادة شرب الخمر وارتكاب المحرمات والفواحش. السؤال الذي يعرض نفسه هنا بارك الله فيكم، ما هي السعادة وما هي الحياة السعيدة وما الطريق إليها؟
So, if the amassment of wealth is not the key to happiness, nor the attainment of high positions and status and high rank, nor is it in the enjoyment of the amenities of this worldly life, nor is it found in fornicating and taking intoxicants and various types of sins. If none of these is the key to happiness, then the question that forces itself upon us at this juncture is, what is true happiness?
والجواب بارك الله فيكم أن الحياة السعيدة لا تكون بالترفه البدن بما ذكرنا من جمع الأموال والتلذذ بملذات الدنيا غير ذلك مما سبق الكلام عنه، وإنما حقيقة الحياة السعيدة أنها شعور داخلي يحسه الإنسان ويتمثل في سكينة النفس وطمأنينة القلب وانشراح الصدر وراحة البال، وذلك نتيجة لاستقامة السلوك الظاهر والباطن المبني على الإسلام والإيمان واتباع سيد الأنام.
So the answer is, may Allah bless you all, that happiness is not the luxuries of the body that are to be enjoyed from the different amenities that we have mentioned examples of. Rather, happiness is an internal state, a feeling that one experiences within themselves, built upon good conduct, both outwardly and inwardly, conduct that is in line with the path of Allah, the law in line with the guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, guidance that is derived from the ways of the leader of all mankind, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
فالإنسان إذا لم يشعر بسكينة النفس وطمأنينة القلب وانشراح الصدر وراحة البال فإنه لا يكون سعيدا في الدنيا.
نعم, the Sheikh Jazahullah Khairan had mentioned something that I skipped unintentionally, and that is that internal state is a state of internal bliss, internal happiness, joy, a state of tranquility and peace, a state of feeling satisfied and happy, irrespective of other states.
حتى لو أعطاه الله سبحانه وتعالى ما طلعت عليه الشمس وغربت.
This happiness is not achieved until that state is accomplished. And if that state is not accomplished, then a person is surely not happy, even if Allah was to give them everything upon the face of the earth.
فإن الراحة الحقيقية إنما هي راحة القلب, ولا يريح القلب إلا الإيمان وذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى والاستقامة على أوامر الله وشرائعه وأحكامه.
For surely, true comfort and true tranquility is the tranquility of the heart. And as for the heart, it will never become tranquil until it is tranquil with the faith, tranquil with the remembrance of Allah, tranquil with the embracement of the commandments of Allah Azza wa Jal, and abstaining from His prohibitions.
ويشعر ذلك من نشأ على الكفر ثم أنعم الله عليه بالإسلام والإيمان أكثر مما يشعره من ولد في الإسلام.
And those who were born into disbelief and then later on accepted Islam are more keenly aware of this internal reality and this internal peace than those who were born into Islam and grew up upon it.
ويشهد لما قلناه من حقيقة الحياة السعيدة الوحي والواقع.
And testimony to that which we have described as the true reality of a happy life, testimony to that is the evidence of the revelation, and likewise what is seen and observed in the world around us.
أما الوحي وهو كلام رب العالمين الذي خلق الخلق ولا أحد أعلم بهم منه.
As for the revelation, then it is found in the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, the revelation of the Lord of all creation, the one who is most intimately knowledgeable of his creation, where he said,
وقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم مبينا أن السعادة في الدنيا والآخرة لا تحصل إلا بالإيمان والاستسلام لله سبحانه وتعالى والانقياد له واتباع نبيه. قال سبحانه: من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. أقسم الله سبحانه وتعالى على أن الحياة السعيدة والطيبة لا تحصل إلا بالإيمان والعمل الصالح.
Allah Azza wa Jal stated in the Quran that this happy life, happiness, is not achieved until one straightens upon the path of Allah, one straightens upon the faith, and one engages in the performance of righteous actions and righteous deeds that follow that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed for mankind. Allah Azza wa Jal said, من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. Whoever performs righteous deeds, be he male or female, whilst a believer, then surely we will indeed grant them a goodly life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala herein, the Shaykh explains, is swearing that this goodly life shall be granted to those who fulfill these two conditions, righteous actions and believing in the faith.
وقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم مبينا أن السعادة في الدنيا والآخرة لا تحصل إلا بالإيمان والاستسلام لله سبحانه وتعالى والانقياد له واتباع نبيه. قال سبحانه: من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. أقسم الله سبحانه وتعالى على أن الحياة السعيدة والطيبة لا تحصل إلا بالإيمان والعمل الصالح.
Allah Azza wa Jal stated in the Quran that this happy life, happiness, is not achieved until one straightens upon the path of Allah, one straightens upon the faith, and one engages in the performance of righteous actions and righteous deeds that follow that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed for mankind. Allah Azza wa Jal said, من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. Whoever performs righteous deeds, be he male or female, whilst a believer, then surely we will indeed grant them a goodly life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala herein, the Shaykh explains, is swearing that this goodly life shall be granted to those who fulfill these two conditions, righteous actions and believing in the faith.
قال الله سبحانه وتعالى أيضا مبينا أن كل ما دعا إليه الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه أو دعا إليه رسوله في سنته هو سبب للحياة السعيدة في الدنيا والآخرة.
And Allah Azza wa Jal has also clarified in his book that everything that he calls to and everything that his messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam calls to is a reason, a factor in the recipe or the equation that leads to the happy life.
فقال مخاطبا عباده المؤمنين: يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. أي استجيبوا لله ولرسوله، لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى إنما يدعوكم لما في حياتكم الطيبة، كما قال ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى في تفسير الآية.
Allah Azza wa Jal said in his book, O you who have believed, respond to Allah and to his messenger. Answer the call of Allah and his messenger if he calls you to that which will bring you life. Meaning, that everything that Allah calls to, everything that Allah commands with, and likewise everything that the Messenger calls to and everything he commands with, is a reason for the attainment of al-hayat al-tayyiba, the goodly life, as explained by al-Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah.
وأخبر الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم أن القلوب لا تطمئن إلا بالدين، فقال سبحانه وتعالى: الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب، فلا طمأنينة ولا راحة ولا سكينة للقلب إلا إذا كان فيه إيمان وكان فيه ذكر لله سبحانه وتعالى.
And Allah has likewise informed us that the hearts will never find tranquility and peace, never find rest, until they are tranquil with the faith, and until they are engaged in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَطْمَئِنُوا قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُوا قُلُوبُهُمْ. Oh, indeed, those who have believed and their hearts find tranquility in the remembrance of Allah. Oh, indeed, it is through the remembrance of Allah that the hearts find tranquility. So Allah herein clarifies that the hearts need the faith and the remembrance of Allah in order to find their tranquility.
وعلى العكس من ذلك بارك الله فيكم، بيّن الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم أن من أعرض عن دين الله سبحانه وتعالى إيمانا وعملا وتطبيقا وانقيادا واستسلاما لله سبحانه وتعالى يعيش في الدنيا في تعاسة، ولا سعادة له ولا راحة له في حياته.
Opposite to that and contrary to that is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us in His noble book that whoever turns away from his religion, turns away from the path of Allah, and turns his back to the commandments of Allah Azza wa Jal, will live a wretched life, an unhappy life, a life of depression.
وقال سبحانه: ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى.
He said, lofty and exalted is he, and whoever turns away from my remembrance, from my revelation, then indeed for him is a life that is dunka, a life that is difficult. And on the day of judgment, we shall resurrect him blind.
فهذا يبين بارك الله فيكم أن السعادة والحياة الطيبة في الدارين بيد الله سبحانه وتعالى، وأنه لا ينالها أحد إلا بالطريقة التي رسمها رب العالمين للسعادة.
So all of this clarifies, may Allah bless you all, that happiness, both in this life and in the life to come, is actually in the hands of Allah. And that no one can attain it unless they follow the path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has delineated, the path that Allah has chosen and clarified for the attainment of happiness.
أما الواقع الذي يشهد للوحي ويبين أن السعادة والحياة الطيبة لا تنال إلا بالدين الحق الذي أنزله الله على عبده ورسوله محمد.
And as for examples from the reality, from the world around us, that show the same thing, that happiness cannot be attained except by way of following in the footsteps of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, following the revelation of Allah, following the commandments of Allah عز وجل.
فهو أولا هو الواقع الذي عاشه النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام وصحابته الكرام، فإنه يعتبر مثالا تطبيقيا للحياة السعيدة في الدنيا والآخرة.
Then foremostly it is that reality that was embodied in the life of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and likewise the life of his companions. The life that they lived is, for lack of a better expression, a living example of what it is to put into practice the goodly life, what it is to put into practice the following of the path of Allah that leads to the goodly life.
وقد كانوا أسعد الناس حياة وأكثرهم راحة، ولم يكن ذلك بكثرة الأموال ولا كذلك بالرئاسات والمناصب وملذات الدنيا، بل كان النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام ينام في كثير من الليالي جائعا، لا يجد من الطعام ما يكسر به الجوع.
And they were the happiest of people. And they were the most satisfied of people. And this was not by the amount of wealth that they had, nor by the position and rank that they had achieved. Rather, this was despite the difficult circumstances they went through, such as hunger. In fact, our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam would many times go to bed hungry, not even having enough food to soften the pangs of hunger.
قد كانت حياتهم الدنيوية بسيطة، بيوتهم من طين، وطعامهم ما يحصل له من المزارع أو من المواشي إذا حصل لهم ووجد، وكانت مراكبهم كذلك من الحيوانات، ومع هذا كانوا أكثر الناس فرحا وراحة وسعادة في الدنيا بسبب الإيمان والإسلام الذي أنعم الله سبحانه وتعالى عليهم به.
Their life was simple. They lived in homes made of mud bricks. They ate whatever came out of the farms and came from the livestock. They would ride on animals, riding beasts. Their life was very simple. Not a life that would be described as lavish by any standard. Yet, they were the most joyous of people and the most tranquil and restful of people. They were the happiest of people, not by way of plentifulness and abundance of wealth, but rather by way of adherence to the faith that had filled their hearts.
هذا بارك الله فيكم مثال واقعي يدل على أن السعادة في الدارين لا تحصل إلا بالدين، بالإيمان والإسلام والعمل الصالح.
This, may Allah bless you all, is a practical example from the reality that we live in that shows that happiness both in this life and the life to come cannot be attained except by way of the faith. An adherence to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following his commandments and abstaining from his prohibitions.
أما الواقع الثاني فهو على العكس من الواقع الأول، هو الواقع الذي يعيشه وعاشه الكفار.
As for the second reality or the second example from reality in the world around us that we can look into as proof for this, then it is the exact opposite of this, and that is by examining the reality of the life of the disbelievers.
وها نحن نرى بارك الله فيكم ونسمع عما جمع هؤلاء من الأموال وما وصلوا إليه من الرياسات والعلوم الدنيوية، ومع هذا يعيشون في أتعس حياة بعيدين عن السعادة وراحة النفس وطمأنينة القلب.
Here we are today listening to and hearing of and witnessing what these disbelievers have reached in terms of the wealth that they are amassing, in terms of the advancements in knowledge and science that they are achieving, the comforts of life in the body that they have engaged in. And yet, despite all of this, they are from the saddest and most wretched of people in their lives, such that they have not attained nor found tranquility, nor peace, nor satisfaction, nor happiness.
وكثير منهم مع ما حصل لهم من صنوف الأموال والرئاسات وما وصلوا إليه من العلوم والتكنولوجيا لا يشعر بالراحة والطمأنينة ولا ينامون نومة هنيئة، بل كثير منهم لا ينامون إلا على الحبوب.
الله أكبر. Many of them despite what they have obtained of wealth and what they have reached in terms of scientific advancement, have not attained tranquility, nor peace, nor happiness. In fact, many of them, despite all of this, cannot even sleep restfully. Surely, many of them cannot even sleep unless they take pills to help them find restful sleep.
ولا زالوا يبحثون عن السعادة، يبحثون عن الحياة السعيدة وعن الحياة الطيبة، يريدون أن يفرحوا، يريدون أن يناموا نومة هنيئة، يريدون الدواء للحزن والهموم والغموم التي أصابت قلوبهم.
And they continue to search for happiness, and they continue to look for peace and tranquility. They are still looking for the solution to the worries and anxieties that plague them. They are still in search, but have not found these things.
وعلى العكس من ذلك نرى كثيرا من المسلمين المؤمنين الفقراء الذين ينامون ويستيقظون على فرح وسرور وطمأنينة قلب وراحة النفس مع قلة ذات يدهم.
And opposite to that, contrary to that, on the other hand, we see many Muslims who go to bed restfully and sleep in tranquility and wake up joyfully and happily despite the lacking in means and not having any abundance of wealth.
فهذا يبين بارك الله فيكم أن السعادة والحياة الطيبة لا تكون إلا بالإيمان وبالاستقامة على صراط الله المستقيم.
So this clarifies, may Allah bless you all, that true happiness and tranquility cannot be found except in the faith and except by straightening upon the path of Allah.
إذا سألت من أنعم الله عليه بالإيمان وكان قبل ذلك في الكفر والشرك والإلحاد، كيف كانت حياته قبل الإسلام وكيف صارت حياته بعد الإسلام، سيخبركم أنه ما شعر بالراحة، راحة النفس وطمأنينة القلب، وأنه ما شعر بالفرح إلا بعد دخوله بالإسلام، مع أنه ما كان ينقصه من ملذات الدنيا شيء.
And if you ask those whom Allah has bestowed the gift of faith upon them, and Allah has guided them to His way, and the ones who accepted Islam after they left the life of disbelief and atheism and the like, if you ask them, they will tell you that we have not found tranquility and not found peace and rest until we accepted Islam. Until Allah Azza wa Jal guided us to His path and guided us to His ways, it is only then that we found these things. Although we never had any lacking in terms of provisions and worldly amenities, but we never found happiness and true joy and tranquility until we were guided to Islam.
معرفة هذه الحقيقة بارك الله فيكم تحثنا وتدعونا إلى أمور.
Realizing this reality, may Allah bless you all, should call us to and encourage us to a number of things.
الأمر الأول أن نحمد الله سبحانه وتعالى ونشكره على ما أنعم علينا به من نعمة الإسلام والإيمان.
The first of these things is that we should express our gratitude to and show our gratitude to Allah for the tremendous blessing that He has granted all of us by making us Muslims.
الأمر الثاني أن نحرص على الازدياد من هذه النعمة، أن نحرص على أسباب زيادة الإيمان، وأن نحرص على الاستقامة على دين الله سبحانه وتعالى والإكثار من الأعمال الصالحة التي نسعد بها في الدنيا والآخرة.
The second thing, this should call us to seek more of this blessing and to want more of this amenity from Allah. We should be keen on gaining more faith and amassing more good deeds that will result in a more tranquil and more satisfying and fulfilling life, a life of faith filled with righteous deeds for the sake of Allah.
الأمر الثالث أن نحرص على تعلم العلم الذي أنزله الله سبحانه وتعالى على عبده ورسوله محمد وتركه إرثا لنا.
The third of these matters is that this should call us to become keen on learning, on gaining the knowledge of the revelation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed upon His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and that His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left behind as an inheritance for us to take.
فالقرآن الكريم وهو أصل جميع العلوم سماه الله سبحانه وتعالى روحا، والروح هي التي يحيا بها الإنسان وكذلك سائر الحيوانات.
And the Quran, the noble Quran, is the foundation of all knowledge. It is the book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called a ruh. Ruh is translated to mean soul. Soul, meaning that thing that brings life. Life to all living beings, all animals, all humans. So it is the Quran that brings you to the true life.
ومن لم يدخل القرآن في قلبه إيمانا وحفظا وعملا به فإنه ليس في حياة حقيقية وإنما هو معدود من الأموات.
The Shaykh Jazallah Khairan clarified, whoever the Quran does not enter his heart, then he is not truly alive, although he may be counted amongst the living.
فالقرآن الكريم وهو أصل العلوم الشرعية إذا لم يدخل في قلب الإنسان إيمانا وخشوعا وعملا فإنه ليس للإنسان حياة حقيقية وإن كان معدودا من الأحياء. فعليكم بالقرآن لتحيوا به حياة سعيدة وحياة طيبة. تعلموا القرآن بارك الله فيكم، تعلموا معانيه وعملوا بالقرآن وكذلك بسنة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام تسعدوا في الدنيا والآخرة.
So upon you is to take the Quran. Take the Quran with diligence. Learn it. Study it. Be keen on understanding its meanings. Adhere to it in order for you to live a happy life with it. And likewise, the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the key to the attainment of the happy life. نعم.
وفي الأخير عليكم بارك الله فيكم وعلينا جميعا أن ندعو الكفار على اختلاف أديانهم ومللهم إلى الإسلام الذي لا يحصلون على الحياة السعادة على الحياة السعيدة والطيبة إلا به.
And in the end, it is upon all of us to call the disbelievers to Islam. To call them to the only way by which they can attain the happy life. They will not be able to achieve happiness, nor ever taste it, until they come to Islam. So we have to call them to it.
وعلينا نشرح لهم ونبين لهم أن الإسلام هو الطريق الوحيد إلى السعادة في الدنيا والآخرة، وأنه السبيل الأوحد إلى الحياة الطيبة، ونبين لهم ذلك بالأمثلة الواقعية وكذلك نقرأ عليهم القرآن كما كان النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يفعل في دعوته. فالقرآن أكثر تأثيرا وأشد تأثيرا من أي كلام.
So it is upon us, may Allah bless you all, to call them to Islam and to clarify it to them and to show them that Islam is the only way for them to attain happiness. And we have to clarify Islam to them with realistic examples. And likewise, to make them hear the Quran. For the Quran is indeed more powerful than any other speech, just like our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite the Quran to the disbelievers. for it is more efficient and has a greater effect than any other speech.
أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعل حياتنا في الدارين حياة سعيدة وأن يحيينا على الإسلام والسنة وأن يميتنا على ذلك وأن يغفر لنا جميعا ولوالدينا وللمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يهدي الضال المسلمين وأن يصلح أحوالهم جميعا حكاما ومحكومين وأن يردهم إلى دينهم ردا جميلا الذي كانت به حياتهم السعيدة وحصلت لهم به العزة والسيادة. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين.
اللهم آمين. استجاب الله دعاءكم شيخنا، وجزاكم الله عنا وعن إخواننا والمستمعين خير الجزاء، ونسأل الله أن يبارك في كلمتكم هذه، وأن يعظم لكم بها الأجر، وأن يعظم بها لإخوانكم النفع.
آمين. الله يبارك فيك، وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجزيك خيرا.
بل أنتم شيخنا، جزاكم الله عنا خيرا، جزاكم الله عنا خيرا.
الله يحفظك ويبارك فيكم.
اللهم آمين. وأنتم شيخنا، أحسن الله إليكم الشيخ، جزاه الله خيرا. Concluded by making a beautiful and beneficial dua, dua for all the Muslims, dua for all of us to be granted the life that is in line with this reminder, a life of tranquility, peace and happiness, a life that embodies embracing the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and leads to happiness. And the Shaykh jazahullah khairan in his dua alluded to the fact that this is the only path that leads to our happiness and likewise leads to our prominence and our victory in this life and in the life to come. We ask Allah to answer his dua, and we ask Allah to reward him lavishly and tremendously and to accept this from him. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to grant us to benefit from these words and to make us from those who will get to enjoy many more of these types of reminders and lectures and talks throughout their days. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك وأنعم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جزاكم الله جميعا خيرا.